हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम शुभांगी, अ पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट स्टूडेंट एट अली अवरजंग नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ स्पीच एंड हियरिंग डिसेबिलिटीज विच इज़ लोकेटेड इन कोलकाता। आई एम हेयर टू प्रेजेंट और प्रोवाइड सम इंफॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग वोकल कॉर्ड पैरालिसिस अंडर द सुपरविजन ऑफ मिस्टर इंद्रनील चैटर्जी, हु इज़ अ लेक्चरर इन स्पीच एंड लैंग्वेज and hearing in our institution. And our institute provides a comprehensive diagnostic therapeutic services to the persons with hearing impairment and speech impairment. So our topic is vocal cord paralysis. It comes under neurogenic voice disorder. So before describing vocal cord paralysis, I would like to describe about neurogenic voice disorders. Neurogenic voice disorders occurs as a part of an underlying neurologic conditions, as for example Parkinson's disease, multiple sclerosis, myasthenia gravis, and or ALS or stroke. And these disorders can affect the strength of the muscles of the larynx and can impact control of voice. So now we can define vocal cord paralysis. It signifies loss of active movements of the true vocal cord or vocal folds, secondary to disruption of motor innervation of the larynx, and can occur at any age or sex. Now, what are the structures involved in speech and voice production? The basic structures are provided in the diagram below, and the vocal folds, which provides phonation, are the two elastic bands of muscle tissues located in the larynx directly above the trachea. Now coming to the nerve supply of the larynx, the recurrent laryngeal nerve and the superior laryngeal nerve provides or supplies the larynx, which are a branch of vagus nerve, that is cranial nerve 8. Also, there are different muscles involved in the production of speech, which are known as laryngeal muscles, which is described in this figure below. And these muscles also plays an important role in production of speech. Now I would like to discuss about the different functions of vocal folds. The vocal folds have mainly two main functions. These are mainly adduction and abduction. Abduction is what? You can say that it is the movement of vocal cords away from each other. That is, the vocal, true vocal cords are going away from the midline. And adduction, it is the approximation of vocal cords with each other. That is, the vocal cords are coming to midline. As you can see in the diagram, the abduction and adduction functions of the vocal cords. Okay, now I am going to discuss about the classification of laryngeal paralysis. It can be divided into two categories, or you can say the bilateral and unilateral paralysis. The bilateral paralysis also includes adductor and abductor, and unilateral laryngeal paralysis also includes adductor and abductor type. And it may include or involve recurrent laryngeal nerve, superior laryngeal nerve, or both, which may be combined or complete. What are the different causes which results in vocal cord paralysis? It can be topographical in manner, and supranuclear, nuclear, high vagal lesions, and it can be idiopathic also. And other causes may include injury to the head, neck or chest, lung or thyroid cancers, tumors of the skull base, neck or chest, and infections like Lyme disease. And neurological conditions also like Parkinson's disease and stroke, as I said earlier. Symptoms of vocal cord paralysis may include hoarseness or breathy work, शॉर्टनेस ऑफ ब्रेथ और नॉइजी ब्रीदिंग, चोकिंग और कॉफिंग, वाइल ईटिंग, लॉस ऑफ वॉल्यूम और पिच, सीरियस प्रॉब्लम्स विद ब्रीदिंग कैन ऑल्सो ऑकर ड्यू टू बायलेटरल वोकल कॉर्ड पैरालिसिस. नाउ हाउ कैन वी से दैट इट इज वोकल कॉर्ड पैरालिसिस? द डायग्नोसिस आर डन बाय ओटोलैरिंगोलॉजिस्ट, लैरिंजियल इलेक्ट्रोमायोग्राफी एंड थ्रू लैरिंजियल एंडोस्कोपी एंड स्ट्रोबोस्कोपिक एग्जामिनेशन वी कैन डिफाइन or we can say that it is a case of vocal cord paralysis. Now we are going to discuss about different types of vocal cord paralysis, which includes the recurrent laryngeal nerve paralysis. It can be unilateral or bilateral, and also the other type includes the superior laryngeal nerve paralysis, which also includes the unilateral vocal cord paralysis or bilateral vocal cord paralysis. And the third one is combined or complete vocal cord paralysis, which include laryngeal and superior nerve paralysis both, which may be combined or complete. And now I am going to discuss about the different vocal cord paralysis causes, clinical features and treatment conditions. So now, as we all are aware about the different types of the vocal cord paralysis and their treatment options. Now I am going to discuss about how voice therapy is important in vocal cord paralysis or in improvement of speech or voice in vocal cord paralysis patient. Voice therapy is done to strengthen the vocal folds and improves breath control during speech, prevent abnormal tension in other muscles around the paralyzed vocal cord or cords, and protect airway during swallowing. And it also helps in unilateral paralysis also. In most of the cases of unilateral paralysis, we can see a much more improvement with voice therapy. And working with an SLP on changing the pitch and getting more breath support to speak louder. The changing the head position of pushing on the larynx may help in voice improvement, and voice therapy is also advised before surgery or other medical treatment also. The task of voice therapy can be divided into indirect procedures, direct procedures, and electronic enhancements. And the indirect procedures includes ongoing collection of history information, counseling, education, vocal hygiene, and maximizing posture. The direct approaches includes the normalization of expiratory drive, decreasing transglottal pressure, enhancing projection, and optimizing medial compression of vocal folds. Apart from these two approaches, that is direct and indirect, the voice therapy part also includes use of electronic enhancements, and it consists of various instruments or using instruments such as portable amplification devices and telephone amplifier to project the voice. Also, it was found that 2/3 of voice therapy treatment time was used in indirect therapy, including description of voice production, counseling, and eliminating postural tension. So we can say that voice therapy is an important aspect in improving speech and voice production of people who have vocal cord paralysis. Although it was a brief introduction about vocal cord paralysis, now I am going to demonstrate
some different voice therapy techniques which were used
in a unilateral vocal cord paralysis.
This strengthens the vocal cords and helps to decrease breathiness while talking. You will say a loud, forceful E sound while pushing palms together. To get the most force, make sure your palms are flat against each other, like so. You should feel tightening in your throat and abdomen during this exercise. Each E sound will be hard and quick, not soft or breathy. Ready? Go!
E, 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 E.
Great. Do 5 sets of 10 unless prescribed otherwise by your speech therapist.
So it was a brief introduction about vocal cord paralysis, and I hope that now you will be able to understand the vocal cord paralysis and their treatment options. Thank you for watching my video.